I grew up in Dallas and did my high school and college there. And then I attended Baylor College of Dentistry, mainly because I had an interest in dentistry because my dad was a dentist and practiced dentistry for many, many years. So I initially attended dental school. Early on in my dental school training, I became interested in some of the surgical aspects of dentistry, particularly oral surgery, and then later oral and maxillofacial surgery. So that made me interested in wanting to go to medical school after I completed dental school. So then I went to medical school, and then after medical school, I did a residency program in oral and maxillofacial surgery, followed by a year fellowship in head and neck surgery. I like to focus on several different areas of oral and maxillofacial surgery. In particular, in the pediatric population, I treat many patients that beginning at from birth until the age of 21 with cleft lip and palate deformities. They're born congenitally with cleft lip and palate, and also kids that are born with abnormal shaped heads, some of the craniofacial conditions and craniofacial syndromes such as craniosynostosis. On the opposite end of the spectrum, I also enjoy treating older patients as well, and many of those patients may have, unfortunately, some of the head and neck tumors that we see in the practice of head and neck surgery. Those include both benign and cancerous lesions in the head and neck, basically anything from the clavicles, from the collarbone up, I'm happy to treat. A particular interest of mine is in jaw surgery. It's sometimes called orthognathic surgery. Ortho meaning straight and nathic meaning jaw. And many patients are born or develop abnormal bites, either underbites or overbites or crossbites. Some of these can be treated solely with orthodontics, and they go to the orthodontist and they get braces and they get that fixed. But there are a significant number of patients that don't fall in that category that can be treated solely with orthodontics because maybe the degree of the underbite or overbite is too severe to be fixed with just braces alone. It needs a combination of braces and surgery. And that's where I come in and do surgery on these folks in conjunction with their orthodontist that does the braces. And these particular procedures, these orthognathic procedures, work well for the treatment of these malocclusions, these bites, abnormalities. But they also can work very well for patients that have sleep apnea, obstructive sleep apnea, which is another area of interest of mine. So we have soft tissue procedures like trimming the soft palate or straightening the septum or taking some of the tongue down in the back. But we also have skeletal procedures where we actually move the jaws forward to open the airway space. And those are also fairly unique procedures, and they work very, very well. We have about a 90% success rate at getting patients off of the CPAP machine that they're tethered, that many people are tethered to, just basically to stay alive. Anytime we do surgery on the face, whether it's for cleft or for tumors or for jaw surgery, we're always trying to put incisions and cuts on the face that are the most cosmetic. So there is a long-standing history for oral and maxillofacial surgeons to do aesthetic surgery or cosmetic surgery of the head and neck. And certainly part of my practice does include forehead lifts, blepharoplasties, rhinoplasties, face and neck lifts, and things like that. That's all within the realm of what I treat. And oftentimes, patients that I did jaw surgery on 25 years ago, they end up coming in for an appointment nowadays, and they say, oh, you know, love to get a facelift or love to get a neck lift or something like that.